Thursday, May 13th. So the moon is in Gemini all day. Curiosity peaked. Information peaked. Focusing in on the details peaked. Want, need, and desire to socialize peaked. Wanting to engage in debates peaked. Wanting to challenge other people's beliefs and opinions peaked, peaked, peaked. So be very careful in engaging in certain conversations. Again, may I remind you, the collective divide has been super apparent for far too long. We are very clear on where people stand. We are very clear whether they are operating from a fear-based system or whether they are operating from New Earth system. And although it's okay to challenge other people's thoughts and opinions and beliefs, please recognize that you cannot change the mind of somebody operating in fear. They cannot hear you. You are speaking a totally different language to them. Dissociative cognitive is a very real thing, especially very apparent here on the earth plane during these times, during the Great Awakening. Be very careful with how it is that you're choosing to trigger people's minds and illuminate new opinions and perspectives for them. There is a huge resistance from fear-based people right now to even open their minds to anything other than the fear-based narrative in which they're already overly attached to. So with that being said, the moon makes seven different aspects today. We're only going to talk about a couple of them because there's other important things going on in the cosmos, really amplifying what the energy of the day is going to be. The first thing that I want to talk about is the moon conjunct with the true node. So the moon in Gemini, the true node in Gemini, they are sitting next to each other. They are having a conversation about the new epiphanies that we would have made of how it is that we are making changes, how it is that we're following this new path forward, how it is that we are healing, how it is that we are disconnecting from old storylines, contracts, energy exchanges, and how it is that we are creating a new foundation for us to build upon as we move away from the old and as we embrace the new. The moon is sextiling Chiron. Chiron is a conversation about healing. Healing ego wounds, healing identity wounds, attachment issues, especially to beliefs, especially to opinions. Why? Because this Gemini energy is strong. May I remind you, Gemini is represented by the twins, one foot in one world, one foot in the other. There is a huge gap, a huge divide that Gemini represents. And our goal under Gemini energy is to find a sweet spot, to find the balance, to find a center and grounding point in between two very extreme polarized thoughts, ideas, choices, and decisions. So the conversation with Chiron is going to illuminate a lot of things for us, especially with the earlier aspect with the true node. We are definitely moving forward. The moon will be trine Saturn. So this is where we get down to earth. This is where we get practical, logical with our planning, right? We need to plan. We need to be logical. We need to make sure that the major changes that we are about to make are the right ones, that we do it in the right manner, that we are calculated enough to see all the ways that we could be challenged, that we could face obstacles, that we could definitely run into brick walls, manifesting a new reality for ourselves. But we're also seeing the progress. We've had a lot of progress in a very short amount of time, especially in our mental planes. We're thinking in a totally different narrative now than we were even this time last week. And that's a very important timeline to follow, because by the time we get done with the month of May, our minds are going to be blown at what position we're in, how our environments change, the people in our lives, the money issues in our lives. We are going through a very pivotal month. And this is just opening up the timeline in our mental planes to think as logically and practically about our plans moving forward as we possibly can do right now with the information that we currently have. The moon is going to be conjunct Mercury. So again, Mercury in Gemini, in his place of power, this is a mental plane issue. This is thinking. This is details. This is communication. This is opinions. This is thoughts. This is ideas. This is beliefs. And you know what? There's a lot of new coming in. There's new thoughts, there's new ideas, there's new conversations, there's new details, there's new narratives, there's new perspectives, all kinds of new. Why? Because we just had the new moon, right? We're starting to see these new ideas come into fruition. We're starting to see these new details manifest in our physical lives. This is an exciting time. And this is why, again, I will encourage you, if you haven't done so already, download the new moon guide. Get in alignment with this energy. It's happening so fast. We are in an accelerated portal of manifestation right now. And again, may I remind you that we are starting to see the things that we are focusing in on come to life within 2 weeks of this new moon energy, putting us smack dab in eclipse season. This is no joke. No joke. So the sun is sextiling Neptune here today, and Jupiter is moving into Pisces. So as I kind of spoke about earlier, again, dive more into the details in May's energy forecast about Jupiter moving into Pisces. Definitely going to be a time, okay? But with the sun sextiling Neptune, and of course, Neptune rules over Pisces. He's in Pisces right now. Jupiter moving into Pisces, this is going to be illuminating the conversation that we are having with ourselves, our higher selves, the universe, divine source. This is our spiritual connection being illuminated, coming to life. This is us questioning things from our inner knowledge source. This is us detaching from the materialistic world around us and moving inwards to gain the insight from our higher selves. This is a connection with spirit. This is a new mission. This is a new truth. This is a new purpose. This is a brand new world that we are jumping into, that we are having a hand in creating. This is new earth. Please, please align with the energies to make sure that you are shifting into 5D and you will not be abandoned on the 4D bridge, and you sure as hell are not remaining in the 3D that will be purged and will be cleansed. Please do your job. Align, elevate, evolve, get in tune with what's going on in the cosmos so that you will not be left behind. This is a big day of energies. This is a big day of shifting. We are beginning to see the moon, the crescent moon, come back in the night sky. This is our green light go to start taking action and making changes in our realm. This is new earth manifesting day by day. It's time to roll up your sleeves and get your hands dirty if you want to all be a part of it, which I know you do, or else you wouldn't be here.